Hey guys, this is Dr. A with Chemistry Basics. We are going to look at the pancreas. So the pancreas is an elongated gland. It's located in the retroperitoneum, so we're just kind of like down deep in there, close to the back. It has both endocrine and exocrine functions as a gland. So the exocrine function, so exo is to secrete out into, so it's going to secrete enzymes into the GI tract. So enzymes and proenzymes. Proenzymes are the inactive form of the enzyme that gets activated in the GI tract. And these enzymes aid digestion. They include the following, and but not limited to trypsin, chymotrypsin, lipase, and amylase. Those are the primary ones that the pancreas will produce as part of its exocrine function. Now, the endocrine portion of the pancreas produces many hormones, including insulin and glucagon, and insulin and glucagon regulate blood glucose. So they're endocrine because it releases these two hormones straight into the bloodstream and not into an open space like the GI system. So that's what's endocrine. And then insulin and glucagon together regulate blood sugar. So insulin kicks in when blood sugar is high, glucagon kicks in when blood sugar is low, and both, you know, will strive to bring the blood sugar back into a normal range. Insufficient insulin production and or insulin resistance leads to diabetes mellitus. So insulin production would be type 1 diabetes, insulin resistance would be type 2 diabetes. I have a video on diabetes and glucose, which you can go review if you need to. Pancreatitis is an inflammation of the pancreas and is the most common disease of this gland. And so in pancreatitis, you will see elevations in two of the primary enzymes that we can measure, and that would be amylase and then lipase. So we're going to look at amylase first. The normal range is 44 to 128 international units per liter. Like all other enzymes, we are mostly concerned with high levels, not low levels. They are secreted by the pancreas and by the salivary glands. Amylase will help digest starches, so breads, pastas, cookies, cakes, crackers, etc. It is most frequently used in the diagnosis of acute pancreatitis. Again, what you're looking for in acute pancreatitis is an elevation in amylase, oftentimes 10 to 20 times the upper limit of normal, if not more. Lipase, its normal range is less than 1.5 international units per mil. The role of lipase in the body is to help fat digestion. It can also be secreted in the tongue, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, and the lysosomes of leukocytes and adipose tissues in lung, milk, liver. It's found in all over the place. And initially, it parallels amylase levels in acute pancreatitis. They increase rapidly and peak at 12 to 30 hours. And again, it would be significantly elevated. And so if both of them are coming up or really high, then this would lead a physician to suspect pancreatitis, especially acute pancreatitis, although there's also chronic pancreatitis. Lipase is more useful for chronic pancreatitis than the amylase. They're often ordered in the ER to assess abdominal pain. All right, that wraps up the pancreas.